This video is based on the Harmony search algorithm. In this video, we will try to understand what is this algorithm all about, how it is working, mathematical models used in this algorithm, and for better understanding, we will try to understand this algorithm with examples. First of all, as you can see here in the population, we have alphabets, and then you can see here in the population, we have numbers. For basic understanding, first we will try to understand this algorithm with alphabets and then with numbers. After that, we will try to understand this algorithm step by step with the numerical example. As you can see here, Harmony search algorithm is introduced in 2001. This is the music-based optimization algorithm that is inspired by the music Harmony. Here you can see the certain rules are followed in this algorithm. As in the real life, musician has three choices. Either they can play the famous piece of music, or they can play something similar to the famous piece of music, or they can compose new music. These three rules are followed in this algorithm, and they play the major role that we will discuss in the upcoming slides. As we know, music is an art of sound arrangements in the time. Here you can see we have sounds such as melody, rhythm, harmony, timbre. So music is an art of sound arrangement in time through different elements. Here you can see certain elements: style, beat, tempo, texture, expression, and pitch. So this algorithm is inspired by the music harmony. Music harmony is the combination of sound pitches in the music. Pitch governs the harmony. It is the aspect of sound that we can hear. Through pitch, we can check whether a musical sound is higher or lower than another musical sound. Music harmony means pitches are played through musical instruments, or they are sung all together at the same time. Now, as we know, music is a combination of sounds, and there is a special relationship between the sound waves that have different frequencies. These sound waves can be created by the musical instruments or by the human voices. Here you can see certain musical instruments that you can use to create music: harp, piano, guitar, and all. So in Harmony search algorithm, we will discuss harmony and pitch. Harmony means the simultaneous occurring of the pitches or the frequencies, or you can say when pitches are played all together at the same time. And pitch refer whether the musical note is higher or lower than the another. Now next you can see we have the music notation that is also known as music notes. Music notes are written on the paper using special symbols. These are the simple instructions how to play the music. So in this algorithm, we will focus on the harmony generation and the pitch adjustment. And for the harmony generation here, harmony memory acceptance rate is used, and for the pitch adjustment rate is used, that we will discuss in the upcoming slides. So first of all, as you can see here in the population, we have the alphabets, and we have 26 alphabets from A to G. So we will generate the harmonies randomly in the first step. So we have three harmony. It means the harmony size we have here 3 in the harmony memory. So first initialize the harmonies randomly. First harmony you can see here, BCD, BCD. Second harmony that is randomly generated is FAG. You can see here. Third harmony is CBD, CB and D. So we have three harmonies that are randomly generated. And we have three musical instruments that are used to generate the sounds. Here you can see by the first instruments we have sound BFC, second instrument sounds CAB, third instrument sound D GD. Third step, evaluate the performance for each harmony. So here, after evaluation, suppose first harmony is best, second harmony is average, third harmony is the worst harmony. After that, in step 4, we will rank the harmonies from best to worst. We will rank the harmony at the top, that is best among all, and worst in the bottom. Right now you can see all the harmonies are in the rank. They are already sorted, so no need to do anything here. After that, in step 5, we will generate here a new harmony. Here you can see new harmony generated is B, B, G. Now, how this harmony is generated? As you can see here, we have 3 musical instruments. First instrument sounds, we have B, F, C. Second instrument sounds, C, A, B. Third instrument sound, D, G, D. So here, we will use the existing harmonies to generate the new harmony. For the first instrument, we have sound VFC. So here, for the new harmony, sound V is taken. And for the second instrument, we have sound C, A, B. And for the new harmony, second sound is taken as B from the second instrument. And third sound we have here G, that is taken from the third instrument. Now we have new harmony BBG. After that, we will evaluate the performance, and then we will check whether the new harmony is better than the worst harmony in the harmony size or not. If the new harmony is better as compared to the worst harmony, then we will replace the new harmony with the worst harmony. Right now, new harmony is this one, and the worst harmony is third harmony. So after evaluation, if the new harmony value is better as compared to the worst, then we will replace. Now we will try to understand this algorithm with the numeric values. You can check the research paper written by the author for this algorithm for more understanding. Now we will try to understand this with numeric values. For example, just imagine the values are taken within the bound 1 to 5, for example. And you can see we have here now 3 design variables. Design variables means 3 music instruments. So we will replace the music instruments with the design variables. For the first instrument, we have design variable x1. Second instrument is replaced with second design variable. Third instrument is replaced with the third design variable, that is x3. And you can see first harmony values are 133, second harmony value 314, third harmony value 415, and the sound that are generated by the first instrument, or you can say the values for the first variable x1, we have 134. For the second variable, values are 311. For the third variable, values are 345. In step 2, using a cost function, that is this one. So here you can see the cost function is used here to evaluate the performance for the harmonies. So here you can see, for example, I'm trying to evaluate the performance for the first harmony. So here, x1 value is 1, x2 value is 3, x3 value is again 3. Put all the values here and I got the value for the first harmony is 8. Like that, compute the values, that is the fitness values for all harmony. After that, we will rank the harmonies based on their fitness values. So here you can see best value is 8, that is minimum. Worst is 39, that is maximum. After that, we will generate the new harmony in the step 4. New harmony, we have 335. So as we know again, first sound, that is 3, is taken from the first instrument. You can see here 3. Second sound from second instrument, you can see here, again 3, third sound from the third instrument, that is 5. So here we have new harmony 3-3-5. Now using this cost function, again we will evaluate the performance for the third harmony. Put all the values, x1 is 3, x2 is 3 and x3 is 5, and I got the value for the new harmony, that is 23. After that, you can see here the new harmony value, you can see 23, and the fitness value for the burst harmony we have 39. Now next step, we will compare the new harmony with the burst harmony. So here you can see the new harmony is better than the burst. So now we will replace the new harmony with the burst harmony in the harmony memory. And you can see this is the harmony memory after the replacement. Here the burst harmony, that is 39. We got the value for 39 for the burst harmony is replaced with the best harmony. After that, we will rank the harmonies based on their fitness values. Right now you can see rank 1, first harmony, rank 2, third harmony, rank 3 is third harmony. Now we will sort them, and you can see here values are among all optimal solution, or you can say the best harmony is the first one, 1-3-3. Now we will try to understand this algorithm step by step. So first of all, we will initialize all the important parameters like pitch adjustment rate, harmony memory adjustment rate, bandwidth, harmony memory size, maximum iteration, dimension means the number of musical instruments, and then we will construct the harmony memory randomly. After that, evaluate the performance using the cost function, and then find out the best and the worst and store that value in the memory. And then we will check the stopping criteria, and after that we have the memory. After that, we will generate the harmony pitch adjustment, and then we will replace, or you can say update, the harmony, and then we will return the best solution. So here you can see parameter initialization phase. For example, we have 4 harmonies. So value for I, we have here 1, 2, 4, as you can see here. Dimension is 2, it means we have 2 musical instruments, first, second, third. You can see here the bounds for the third space, lower is -10, upper bound is 10, and maximum iteration we have 10, pitch adjustment rate 0.25, and harmony memory adjustment rate is 0.95. Now next question is how we can initialize the harmonies randomly. Now you can see we have the bounds. Lower bound is -10, upper bound is 10. U is here upper bound, L is here lower bound, and this is the normally distributed random value. So here you can see we have 2 music instruments, or you can say we have 2 dimension. So here for position x11, it means for the sound x11, we will generate the value. Lower bound -10, any random value. Lower upper bound is 10, and again lower bound, and we got the value here, this one. After that, for the second position, it means for the second sound, like that we will calculate the values for all. For example, here we have the bound. So now here you can see we have the bound within -100, that is the lower bound, and 100, that is the upper bound. And you can see all the values are within the bound. So here you can see, after that we will evaluate the performance using any cost function, and then we will find out the best and the worst and store in the memory. Best is 39, worst is 68. After that, check the stopping criteria, and then we will create the new harmony using the harmony memory adjustment rate and pitch adjustment rate. So here we will check whether the random value, here rand is the uniformly distributed random value, for example 0.09754, within the range 0 and 1. Harmony memory adjustment rate is here, you can see. So here we will check whether the random value is less than the harmony memory adjustment rate or not, and then we will choose the existing harmony randomly. As you can see, we have As you can see here, we have three rules. First, musician can play the famous piece of music that is known. So it means we are using the value from the harmony memory. And second, we will do slight adjustment in the pitch. It means musician is playing something similar to the famous piece of music. Third option we have, we can compose new music. That is, here we are generating the random value. Like that, you can see here, if the random value is less than the harmony memory acceptance rate, then we will choose any existing harmony from the harmony memory, and then we will do pitch adjustment, and then we will compare the solution, and after that we will return the best as the optimal solution. So here you can see, first we will start with parameter initialization. It means the maximum number of iteration, population size, it means how many memory size, and musical instruments, it means the dimension and all, and how many memory is initialized randomly, cost evaluation using the cost function, or you can say objective function. Then counter, we have current iteration 1, and you can see the dimension, we have 2 instrument, then j is first 1. After that we will check the value for j is equal to 2. So here, if dimension is 10, then value for j is 1 to 10. After that we will check the harmony memory acceptance rate. If this condition is true, then we will select the harmony from the harmony memory. Randomly we can select any harmony. And here, if this condition is not true, then we will generate any random number, and then again we will check the dimension. If it is not true, then we will increment the value for j, and again we will check this condition. If this condition is true, then we will select any harmony from the harmony memory randomly, and then we will check the pitch adjustment rate. If this condition is true, then we will perform the pitch adjustment, and then we will check again the dimension. If this condition is true, then we will move to the next slide, it means the next step. If this condition is not true, then again increment this and again perform all this. After that, you can see here, we will evaluate the harmony memory performance, and then we will check whether the new harmony is better than the burst or not. If this condition is true, then we will replace the new harmony with the burst harmony in the harmony memory, and then increment the counter, and then again, and here increment the counter, and then again we will start from here, and then again we will start from here, and in the end we will return the best solution. So that's all about this video. If any question, you can comment below, and thanks for watching this video.